Like most bros, I have many fond memories of the gym, but perhaps one of the most dear to my heart is the day I first tried reworking. As though it was yesterday, I remember asking my swole mate, John, what it was like, and he said something like,
"It's good, bro. It makes you tingle."
Contrary to popular belief, though, you aren't tingling because you've just overloaded your system with enough stimulants to win a horse race. In reality, the tingling is a side effect of a powerful endurance-promoting supplement known as beta-alanine. I know what you're thinking. Beta? I don't like it already. Although the supplement companies love using it because of the immediate tingling effect, it actually does have some very alpha benefits. In order to explain how beta-alanine works, though, it's important to explain where your strength comes from. Muscles get energy from a magical molecule called ATP, but they have different ways of making it depending on how much they need. If you try and do any physical activity flat out, you'll notice that you quickly become weaker. Well, this is because your muscles are running out of ATP. They have three primary ways of making it. The first method gives them a ton of energy. That's why they tap into it first, and hence why you have the most power during the first few seconds of an activity. Then there is an intermediate way of making energy, and finally a slow drip one. Now these systems aren't simply on or off, they do work throughout the entire activity as you can see, but remember, as time passes and the muscles go through the different energy sources, the overall power available is also going down. For example, 200 seconds in, nearly 80% of the power is coming from the slow drip aerobic source. That is because the much better energy sources have already fizzled out. Let's look at the total power available, and I'll color code it based off which system is doing the majority of the work. The ATP-CP system is that initial rush of power, and is responsible for the majority of the energy used within the first few seconds of, say, a sprint, or depending how long you spend during a rep, generally the first 1 to 3 reps. After those first few seconds are up, your body switches to glycolysis as the main energy source. This is from about 10 seconds to 75 seconds. During this time, the ATP-CP system is still helping out a bit, but glycolysis, or the breakdown of glycogen, is primarily where you're getting your ATP from. After about 75 seconds, the power output slowly falls until it is the weaker, slow-drip aerobic system which is giving the majority of the power available. Why? Because the byproduct of glycolysis, lactic acid, begins to build up. It's piling up faster than the muscles can flush it out. At a point, the lactic acid becomes too much, glycolysis slows down, and you're left with the slow-drip energy source of the aerobic system. So if after 75 seconds a slow drip is where we're getting the majority of our power from, no wonder you aren't very strong at that moment. So imagine if there was a way to take that middle system and give it a boost. Remember how I said the lactic acid buildup is what hinders glycolysis? Well, what if we could make the blood more basic to cancel out some of that lactic acid buildup? That is essentially what beta-alanine does. When beta-alanine is ingested, it turns into the molecule carnosine, which acts as an acid buffer in the body. Carnosine is stored in your muscles and released in response to drops in pH. Increased stores of carnosine offer protection from exercise-induced lactic acid production. This allows your body to use that better intermediate energy source for longer, and ultimately gives you greater power output. Remember how I talked about horse races before? Well, it actually turns out the highest natural carnosine levels are found in the muscles of horses and racing dogs. This explains why many people who take beta-alanine and thus raise their carnosine levels report being able to perform 1 or 2 additional reps in the gym when training in sets of 8 to 15 reps. Beta-alanine also improves moderate to high intensity cardiovascular exercise performance like rowing or sprinting. In football players, 4 grams a day improved performance on the shuttle run, flexed arm hang, and their body composition. There is one heavily referenced meta-analysis in which athletes saw a 2.85% boost when training between 60 seconds and 240 seconds, and the benefit continued even after 240 seconds to a lesser degree. And since most people train in multiple sets, the faster the lactic acid is cleared, the less time you'll need to rest between sets. I also have a theory that in multiple set training, when the aerobic system kicks in the second and third time, it will give you energy more similar to what you would have had on the first set since there's less lactic acid left over from the last set. Oh, and as for that tingly feeling, it's called paresthesia and it's completely harmless. If you don't like it though, you can always spread out your beta-alanine intake over the course of an entire day. In fact, this might be better, since in a 5-week study of healthy subjects supplementing with 4.8 grams of beta-alanine daily, muscle carnosine increased more when beta-alanine was taken with meals than when it was taken between meals. Although there are a lot of sham supplements out there, this is one which will definitely benefit a lot of people. I hope you enjoyed that breakdown, and let me know what supplement you want me to cover next. Until next time, D-Man, signing off.